This is hip mobility, the front hip circle. Before you begin the front hip circle, you want to make sure that you know your rehab position. To find out your rehab position, you're going to get in a single leg stance, lock out your knee, and from the hip, you want to go into external rotation and then internal rotation. And just take a qualitative assessment on how both of those feel, and you want to figure out which one is actually harder for you to be in. If you look at my leg, external rotation is pretty easy, but internal rotation, I'm kind of running into a wall and I don't have a great ability to internally rotate. So internal rotation would be my rehab position for all of the four position hip circles. For the front hip circle, you're going to start in a neutral stance, tall spine, bring your leg out in front of you, make sure you have a balance check like a chair or the wall. I'm going to go into my rehab position, which is internal rotation. Once I wind up that internal rotation, I want to make sure my foot is relaxed and my knee is locked out. Keep that tall spine, and I'm going to begin drawing circles in front of my body, making sure that my foot stays relaxed, my knee stays locked out, and that my pelvis doesn't hike up. Oftentimes the pelvis wants to drive this motion. We're trying to differentiate between the pelvis and the hip. We want the motion to come directly from the hip. You're going to draw circles both clockwise and counterclockwise. If you feel any rough or glitchy spots in your circle, spend more time moving through that spot. Common mistakes: holding the breath, flexing forward, sort of watching what you're doing. It's really important that as you do this, you do maintain that tall spine and that you try to balance tension and relaxation. This is the front hip circle.